Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to talk about LFOs and how to create inside Ableton. There are many ways to create LFOs, and actually there are some third-party plugins which is very practical as well, but I'll talk about how we can do inside Ableton. And actually, LFO means low frequency oscillator, but it is technically more than that for me. You can create tremolo, vibrato, like this kind of, if I'm gonna make it from my mouth, like or all these effects are coming from LFO. So in Ableton there are lots of ways to do. Let's create something really simple at first to understand better about LFOs. For example, here, let's create more. Yeah, I will create something really simple here. Okay, we created something really, really simple here. Let me quantize it really quick. So, before going to the real, exactly, LFOs, how you can do like LFO kind of effect in a simplest way, I think it's Arpeggiator. It pretty does the same effect. Actually, if it was just one note, like one simple da-da-da, we would be able to use anything from here, but since it's a chord, I will choose chord trigger, and there is rate. There's another option. So you can use this like as an LFO. It's not exactly LFO, but you can use this. The other way is, for example, let me create automations. We will create a volume automation. I would do the automation from here, but if you're gonna do the automation from this section, you're gonna have problem in mixing. So we'll use utility, because you know how we can get the most benefit from LFO is like giving the LFO effect to the volume. Of course, you can give it to the anything like reverb effect, like your other effects, but the most beneficial thing is giving effect to the volume. So actually right now we are creating, by doing so we are creating LFO by our hands. You see, for example, click on a really small section, for example, like however you want. I created a wave here by right clicking, and like I'm then Control D duplicating it. For example, it's coming too much because the upper section is exceeding 0 decibel. There is also a way to fix that. We are gonna highlight the area, and then we are gonna. You see, this is LFO effect, for example, and but this is not practical because if you want to make it shorter, you can use Control and yeah, like this kind of stuff inside automation. But this is really crazy and not practical, as I said. For example, we created the LFO there, here. For example, we have LFO here. We just created from automation. But this is not practical, as I said. But of course, in music production, you can get benefit of automations as well. Let's delete the automation from here. Okay, now this is the sound we have. Now we're coming to the real LFO. It's in the modulator section of L here. Got it? So we are going to map, as I said, and previously I said, we're going to connect to the, let's make this wavetable small. We are going to connect LFO to the volume. So what we are going to do here, we're going to create like, actually there's more like we can make it like this, but you see the gain is going too much. This would be really fucked up, honestly. You can, of course, like from this section, you can arrange like by getting down to the percentage. And yeah, you see, like it's going to do 0 decibel here if you arrange it to the 50%, something like that. It's like, yeah, now it's going like this. And you can play with its rate. There is also like rate, also as like rhythm like this. You can choose as hertz or like rhythm numbers. This is my favorite, my personal favorite, 116. And also, if you don't want to deal with the percentage here, you can do like this. You can select both of them, then Control G. After creating a group, like here is just the macro. And we will not map to the gain. We will map to the macro. And also we will make the gain to the macro one as well. So both this and this one is inside here. And when we click on the map, you will see the max decibel of our selection. I would like to put as zero, something around there, because otherwise it will be too high. Now it's given the same effect. Now you can play with its rate. Okay, how we can utilize this idea, like this is it, actually, what I was going to show you, this is it, but how you can utilize it, like adding compressor, like sidechaining the kick, etc., this kind of stuff. By the way, inside Ableton, you'll see, for example, auto filter. After I add auto filter, for example, let's not use here. There are some plugins inside Ableton which gives automatically LFO section here, you see? So these are the most practical way to create LFOs in my opinion. Thanks for watching. Also, after creating this kind of LFO effects, you can enjoy your MIDI keyboard, or I don't know, like you can do anything you want. You can use inside arrangement section. Also, you can use like this. Something like that. It's not perfect. I don't know how to play piano at all. At all. I'm just making it up. Yeah, but you can use LFO for this kind of things. By the way, there are some third-party plugins who also creates LFOs, like Shaper Box, for example, from Cable Guys. Like there are also like presets here, but you can also create like volume and like Here you see the waves, and like you see, you can use this kind of stuff as well, like third part plugins. I just like, for example, I'm closing the volume and width. For example, I just add volume. I just chose a wave. Then I just X2, like. That was too much, for example. That's better for me. You can arrange, like, you know, according to yourself. This is pretty practical as well. And for example, there's also another plugin like this. What was its name? Biome, I guess. Yeah, for example, and we are gonna choose modulation. We're gonna go to modulation because LFO effect is a modulator. Let me see, this is giving the same effect like we made on Ableton. There are other stuff here, but like they're all, you know, doing the same thing on the basement. Yeah, thanks for watching again.